बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास, होप यू विल बी फाइन। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज प्रोस्टाग्लैंडिंस। एज यू नो द प्रोस्टाग्लैंडिंस आर अ कॉम्प्लेक्स ग्रुप ऑफ लिपिड्स डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द साइक्लिक सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स। So we will see in detail what are the prostaglandins, what are their function, and what is their structure, and if they have some side effects as well. So if we exactly define what are the prostaglandins, we can say that any of a group of hormones like substances produced in the various tissues and that are derived from the amino acids, and they can mediate a range of physiological functions. So it's a group of hormone like substances, is not a single macromolecule. Prostaglandins are a group of hormone like structures and it's not a single macromolecule. So we should see the history of the prostaglandins. Prostaglandin first of all discovered in the 1930s by the Ulf von Euler. Ulf von Euler was a German physiologist. He found that the seminal fluid and seminal vesicle from most animals, including the man, a substance which causes contraction of the smooth muscles of the uterus, and he named it prostaglandins, since they were originally thought to be secreted by the prostate glands. In 1945, Bergstrom met this physiologist and he was conducting the research on the prostaglandins. Together they conducted research on how the prostaglandins are formed. During 1950, Bergstrom uses the countercurrent extraction device, which was made by the Lehmann Kreich, and he was able to find the chemical structures of the prostaglandins. He also discovered the prostaglandins are formed by the conversion of the unsaturated fatty acid. Up to the 1960s, his research was successful and he teamed up with the Samuelson in conducting the further research on the prostaglandins. Together with the Samuelson, they worked on how the prostaglandins are formed and metabolized. And in early 1960s as well, Vanne created and upgraded the procedure known as the biological assay or bioassay. By the use of this assays method, he learned that prostaglandins are produced by many tissues and organs and not just by the prostate. In another study conducted in the 1969, he found the methods by which the aspirin alleviates the pain and reduces inflammation. Vanne also discovered the existence of prostacycline, which was found to be of great importance in dissolving blood clots. So collectively on these research, Suneke, Bergstrom, Bengtel, Samuelson and John Orr, Vanne were awarded Nobel Prize in the Physiology or Medicine of 1982 for their discoveries concerning the prostaglandins and related biological active substances. The chemical structure of the prostaglandins. Chemical structure of the prostaglandins, as discovered by the Olof von Euler. All the prostaglandins are considered to be derived from the 20 carbon cyclic saturated fatty acid, prostanoic acid. The structure of the prostanoic acid is given in the video, and it is a 20 carbon saturated cyclic fatty acid, and the 5 carbon ring of its cycle is also saturated. All the naturally occurring prostaglandins have an alpha oriented group, a hydroxyl group at the carbon number 15. And if we classify the prostaglandin on the basis of its structure, it can be classified into the series 1 contain the one double bond from the linoleic acid. Series 2 contains the two double bonds and from arachidonic acid. And series 3 contains the three double bond icosapentaenoic acid groups. Naturally occurring prostaglandins belong to the two series. Prostaglandins are not stored, however their precursors, fatty acids, are stored in the membrane as the phospholipids. And the formation of the prostaglandins, arachidonic acid is released by the action of the phospholipases A2 on the phospholipids. This synthesis is catalyzed by the prostaglandins H synthase. It contains the two separate enzymes, cyclooxygenase and peroxidase. PGG2 and PGH2 are formed as the intermediates during the synthesis of the prostaglandins. In the pathway of the prostaglandins synthesis or the biosynthesis of the prostaglandins, you can see that phospholipids of plasma membranes with the help of the phospholipases A2 cleavage converted into arachidonate further cleavage with the help of the cyclooxygenase and the prostaglandin synthase into the prostaglandin H2. And if there is an action of lipoxygenase, it will also produce the leukotrienes. Prostaglandin H2 further converted into the prostacycline with the help of the prostacycline synthase, and the thromboxane synthase converted the prostaglandin H2 into the thromboxanes, and prostaglandins with the help of other enzyme also converted into other prostaglandins like PGD2 and the PGE2. And we should know that arachidonate is the major precursor of several classes of signals molecules like prostaglandins, prostacyclines, thromboxanes and leukotrienes. These different prostaglandins then acted by the specific isomerases, and in the different tissues there are the different type of the prostaglandins and different isomerase of the prostaglandins, which are visible with their name and with their tissue structure in the video, and you have to remember that one. Now come to the functions of the prostaglandins in the body, in the metabolism and in the normal physiology. Prostaglandins act on an array of cells and have a wide variety of effects, such as do the vasoconstriction and vasodilation of the muscles. And they induce the labor pain at the time of the delivery. The pathway of this labor pain is that estrogen from the ovaries induce the oxytocin receptor on the uterus. That oxytocin stimulate the uterus to contract and also stimulate the placenta to make. At that place, prostaglandins stimulate more contraction of the uterus, and this more contraction will give the positive feedback for the production of more oxytocin, and that more oxytocin stimulate the placenta to make. So in this way, they induce the labor pain and help in the child delivery. Intraocular pressure. IUP is a fluid pressure inside the cell measured with a tonometer. Normal intraocular pressure be 10 to 20 millimeter of mercury, and prostaglandins decreases the intraocular pressure by increasing the removal of aqueous humor from the eye, and it also regulate the inflammation. Prostaglandin also proliferate the cell growth, and especially the prostaglandin E2 stimulate the growth of the skeletal muscles. And it also acts on the thermoregulatory center of hypothalamus to produce the fever. Hypothalamus helps to regulate the body temperature. Prostaglandin also act on the mesangial cells, specialized smooth muscle cells, in the glomerulus of the kidney to increase the glomerular filtrate. They also act on the parietal cells in the stomach wall to inhibit the acid secretion. There are some other function of prostaglandins, which are that they sensitize the spinal neuron to pain, causes the aggregation or the disaggregation of platelets, and also regulate the calcium movement and the hormones. They regulate the hormones and the brain masculinization in rats. There are some adverse effects of the prostaglandin as well, and that are we can see a major adverse effect on the GIT system, gastrointestinal tract system. It is seen that in the GIT system, longitudinal muscles is contracted by the PGE2. Circular muscle is contracted strongly by the PGF2-alpha and weakly by the PGI2. Administration of the PGE2 result in the colloquy cramps. Misoprostol causes abdominal discomfort and occasional diarrhea. Effects on the female reproductive system is TXA2 low concentration of PGE2 contracts the uterine muscles, and disturbed menses is also seen in some time. On the male reproductive system, prostaglandin causes the pain in the penis if taken in excess. Effects of the prostaglandin on the cardiovascular system. In the most vascular beds, PGE2, PGFI2 and PGD2 elicit the vasodilation and drops in the blood pressure. PGE2 can cause the vasoconstriction through the activation of EP1 and EP3 receptors. Now, LTC4 and LTD4 result in the hypotension. There are some general side effects of the prostaglandins that are the nausea, diarrhea, hypotension, headache, and nasal stuffiness sometimes occur if the concentration of the prostaglandin increases or decreases. Thank you. I hope all of these contents about the prostaglandins will help you to get the good marks in the exam. For this, you have to remember the different classes, different isomers of the prostaglandins in the different tissues and organs and their function, because they can be included in the MCQs of your exam. Thank you.